Before you throw that old battery away, what if there's a simple way to make it charge and work like new again? Most people think once a car battery dies, it's done for good, but that's not always true. With a few simple steps and materials you probably already have at home, you can bring it back to life and save the cost of a new one. In this video, I'll show you exactly how to drain, clean, refill, and recharge an old battery so it works like new again. It's safer and easier than you might think, and the results will surprise you. So grab your tools and let's get started. Start by placing the old battery on a flat, well-ventilated surface. Always wear gloves and safety glasses. This step involves acid, so protect yourself. Using a flat screwdriver and a small hammer, gently pry open the plastic caps on top of the battery. Take your time here. The caps can be tight after years of use. Once they're loose, carefully tilt the battery over a plastic tray and pour out the old electrolyte. You'll notice the liquid looks dark or cloudy, that's normal. Over time, lead sulfate builds up inside, reducing the battery's ability to hold a charge. Removing this old acid is the first big step toward bringing the battery back to life. Make sure to keep the tray in a safe spot and never pour the liquid down the drain. It's important to handle it responsibly. When the battery is empty, set it upright and let it drain for a few more minutes before moving to the next step. Once the old acid is completely drained, it's time to give the battery a good rinse. Fill a small container with clean tap water and slowly pour it into each cell until they're about 3/4 full. Close the caps loosely, then gently shake the battery for a few seconds to help loosen up any leftover residue or sulfate buildup inside. Be careful not to spill and avoid shaking too hard, just enough to let the water move around. After that, pour the water out into the same tray you used earlier. You'll probably see it come out gray or dirty. That's a good sign. It means the inside is getting cleaned. Repeat this process one more time to make sure all traces of the old acid are removed. When the water finally comes out clear, you know the battery's ready for the next step. This simple rinse makes a big difference, helping the battery plates reset and prepare to hold new electrolyte again. Let me know where you're watching from. It's always fun to see this little community grow. Now that the battery is rinsed clean, it's time to neutralize any leftover acid inside. Grab a small box of regular baking soda, the same kind you use in the kitchen. Pour a few tablespoons into the battery cells, then carefully add clean water until they're about half full. You'll notice a bubbling reaction right away that's the baking soda, working, neutralizing the remaining acid and breaking down buildup on the plates. Let the mixture sit for a few minutes so it can do its job. After that, gently swirl or tilt the battery to make sure the solution reaches every corner inside. When the bubbling slows down, pour out the liquid safely into your tray. This step helps prevent corrosion and extends the battery's life once it's restored. It's a simple trick, but it makes a big difference in how well your battery performs after recharging. After the cleaning and neutralizing steps, it's time to bring the battery back to life with fresh electrolyte. Make sure the inside is completely empty and dry before refilling. Using a plastic funnel, carefully pour new battery electrolyte, usually a mix of sulfuric acid and distilled water, into each cell up to the fill line. Take your time and avoid overfilling. Once all the cells are topped off, gently tap the sides of the battery to release any trapped air bubbles. This helps the fluid settle evenly. When you're done, wipe off any spills around the caps and let the battery sit for a few minutes before sealing it. This fresh electrolyte is what restores the chemical reaction that makes the battery work again. Now that the battery has been refilled, it's time to seal it properly to prevent any leaks. Use a small amount of clear silicone around the edges of each cap. Silicone works great because it keeps moisture out and holds up well against heat and vibration. Once applied, press the caps back into place firmly, making sure each one is tight and secure. Wipe off any extra sealant with a clean cloth, then let it dry for about 15 to 20 minutes. This simple sealing step protects the new electrolyte inside and keeps your battery safe and long-lasting. Once the battery is sealed, it's time to give the outside some attention. A clean battery doesn't just look better, it also works better. Start by spraying a bit of WD-40 on both terminals and around the surface. The spray helps loosen any corrosion or grime that's built up over time. Take a piece of fine sandpaper and gently polish each terminal until the metal shines. This step is important because it improves electrical contact and ensures a stronger connection when you hook it up later. After sanding, spray a little more WD-40 and wipe everything down with a paper towel or dry cloth. You'll notice the surface looks clean, smooth, and like new again. Finally, make sure the top of the battery is completely dry and free from oil before charging. A clean and well-maintained surface keeps the current flowing efficiently and helps prevent power loss in the future. Now it's time to recharge the battery and see the results. Connect the charger's positive lead to the positive terminal and the negative lead to the negative terminal. Set your charger to a low, steady charge around 12 to 24 volts depending on your battery type. Let it charge slowly for several hours. You'll notice small bubbles forming inside the cells. That's a good sign the chemical reaction is working again. Once fully charged, your old battery is ready for use. And there you have it, a fully restored car battery brought back to life with just a few simple steps. You didn't need any fancy tools or expensive products, just a little time and some basic know-how. Now your old battery is working like new again, and ready for more miles ahead. If you found this guide helpful, hit the like button and subscribe for more practical home repair ideas. Let me know in the comments where you're watching from. I always enjoy hearing from you. Thanks for watching and see you in the next project.